Today I am reviewing a pair of loudspeakers and an amplifier with built-in DAC for under $500. Is it worth it? Let's find out. So in this review I am looking at the SA200IA amplifier in combination with the S5B loudspeakers from Sound Artist. I review them as a set, but of course I will also share my thoughts on the amplifier and the loudspeaker separately. So here's my story. I got these loudspeakers from my friend and YouTuber Andrew. His channel is Vintage Stereo and he is actually the one that got this set for review. He got this equipment from China and they are okay with me doing a review. So I want to thank them both for making this possible. However, being an audiophile, I'll just want to play with all this wonderful stuff, so let's get started. But first we have to set up the system. Now the set itself retails for around $450, consisting of a 87 dB 6-ohm loudspeaker with a very interesting looking tweeter that they call a silk film tweeter with a very pointy sound guide. According to specs, you can feed them 15 to 250 watts of power. The tweeter measures 3 inch and is accompanied by a 5-inch woofer. The box looks very nice, although I don't think this is real veneer, but that is acceptable at this price point. The price for the loudspeakers is $199 a pair. It has two pairs of binding posts at the rear and it is a ported design and the port is also at the rear just below the binding posts. The amplifier is a class AB design with 200 watts per channel available at 4 ohms. Now let's have a look at the front of the amplifier. So what do we have on the front? Well, we have the power button to turn on the amplifier, you have your selector switch and the indicators for the selection. So you have CD, DVD, your line, your optical or coaxial inputs, because this has a internal DA converter. And one more click and you don't see any lights on the buttons because now it is on mute and now it is on CD again. This is for the remote control. You have a nice solid volume knob and you have your button to turn on and off tone control for treble and bass control, and that's it. And here we have the rear of the amplifier. Let's see what we have here. So we have inputs and outputs. Two inputs, one for CD, one for DVD, two outputs. During editing, I discovered this little mistake. There are three inputs, CD, DVD, and line, and there's one output, either for a preamp or a subwoofer. One for line, and one output is called output, and in the manual, they say this is for a subwoofer output. You have the two digital inputs, optical and coaxial. Now you cannot use two of them because you cannot switch between them. If you have both connected, it will prefer the optical input instead of the coaxial input. Then we have, of course, the binding posts for the loudspeakers, right side, left side. And over here we have the power input, and that's it.
So what are my first impressions of this set? Well, when I first set them up and listened to it, I was not very impressed. Bass was a bit overwhelming and it all sounded a little bit flat. Now the reason I'm saying this is because that first impression completely changed after a week of play. If you are skeptical of break-in or burn-in, you should really get yourself a fresh set of this amp and loudspeakers to convince yourself. So what happened when I played the set a little longer? Well, I was still not blown away. This was not audiophile quality and there were some limitations, but it was not bad either. Now what do I mean by that? Well, here's the thing. If you just want a stereo set that plays very nice and will never give you any listening fatigue, this is a very good option. However, if you want to sit in your favorite listening position to experience depth and a wide soundstage and great placement, this is not the set for you. Also, if you want to play it very loud, you should look somewhere else. It becomes too edgy when you play it really, really loud. Many times I had to grab the remote control to turn the volume down a little bit. However, and I repeat, if you want a stereo set that you just want to play every day without too much audiophile aspirations, this set is really, really nice. Now, if you think this is the end of the story, you are very, very wrong, because something amazing happened after this. After reviewing the Sound Artist set as a whole, I started playing around with other loudspeakers. So I hooked up a pair of Lin Katan loudspeakers, and what happened after that completely took me by surprise. The sound I was hearing was really very, very good. What happened? Well, after some more changing of loudspeakers, it was clear. The SA200 IA amplifier is the big surprise here. This amp can play way above its price tag of $250. Now, for that kind of money, it is not perfect, of course. But man, this thing was really a surprise. Pair this amp with the correct set of loudspeakers and it really sings. Imaging was much better, voices came to life, and the sound was much more involving. So is this amp audiophile? Well, it is standing at the doorstep. There is still a little bit too much bass, and when driven too loud, some sibilance will creep in and the level of realism is not as good as a well set up audiophile system. But if you take the time to carefully match this amp with the correct set of loudspeakers, cables, and a good source, this is a real steal at $250. Now that being said, I have to talk about the built-in DA converter. Sound Artist claims it is mostly intended for use with a TV, but I still wanted to see how it compared to my 15-year-old Arcom CD player. So I connected the Arcom via digital and via analog to the amplifier so I could switch between analog and digital in order to check the differences between the built-in DAC from the Sound Artist amplifier and the DAC in my Arcom CD player. And this was just no contest. The analog connection gave me much better sound, much more involvement and much more realism, for example. I have to say though, the built-in DAC was much cleaner sounding. The Arcom DAC, being 15 years old now, was, in comparison, a bit muddy in the details. The built-in DAC did a better job of defining small details, so there is progression in DAC performance, but the sound was just a bit too flat and uninvolving to be enjoyed as much as the analog signal from the Arcom. So I consider the built-in DAC a nice to have feature, but I would recommend a good source because this amp really, really surprised me. Now only if they can fire the guy that decided that this amp needed fake plastic looking gold feet. And the last gripe I have with this amp is... DVD? Really? So, in conclusion, as I said, I would not recommend this. And that is only because the pairing with the S5B loudspeaker is not optimal. If you do want a complete Sound Artist set that will impress you, I suggest you save up for the LS35A version that they produce. I will tell you in a separate review about the LS35A, but this combination had me enjoying some very late night listening sessions. So partner the Sound Artist SA200 IA amplifier with the correct loudspeakers, some good cabling and a good source, and this amp plays well above its price tag. So here's a short recap. I like the inexpensive S5B loudspeaker from Sound Artist. It sounds nice, but imaging and soundstage could be much better. And when I say it is not audiophile, I mean it does not have the capability to involve you into the music as some of the better loudspeakers can. Now, for $199 a pair, that is nothing to be ashamed of, and if you want a loudspeaker to play all day for not too much money, you should really consider the Sound Artist S5B loudspeaker. As for the Sound Artist SA200 IA amplifier, this is a very good amplifier for the money. I have no problem recommending this one for aspiring audiophiles. But a lot depends on the other equipment in your system, so pay some attention to finding a good match. And so we come to the end of this review. But don't click away just yet, because there is a sound sample coming up of the Sound Artist S5B loudspeaker and the SA200 IA amplifier. If you like this review, give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing if you haven't already. And as always, I am not a fan of sound samples because through my mediocre recording equipment, the compression of YouTube and whatever equipment you are using, there is no way that you experience what I experience here in my setup. But it is also my only way to give you a bit of an impression, so that is why I choose to do it anyways. So enjoy, and here it comes.
No girl made has got a shade on. Shh. Two left feet, but also need her sweet. They all sigh and want a devil sweet. I tell you just why, you know I don't lie. It's been said she knocks him dead when she lands in town. Since she came, why it's a shame how she cools him down. Fellas, she can get a fellas, she ain't meant. Georgia claimed her, Georgia named her, sweet Georgia Brown. No girl made has got a shade on sweet Georgia Brown. Two left feet but also need her sweet Georgia Brown. They all saw one of that for sweet Georgia Brown. I tell you just why, you know I don't lie, not much. All those tips to put her slips to a sweet Georgia Brown. They buy clothes at fashion shows with $1 down. Oh boy, tip your hats, hold yours. She's the cat, who's that mister? Ain't her sister, sweet Georgia Brown. But also need her sweet Georgia Brown. They all sigh, one of that for sweet Georgia Brown. I tell you just why, you know I don't like no, not much. It's been said she knocks him down when she lands in town. Since she came, why it's a shame how she cools him down. Fellas, she can get a fellas, she ain't met. Georgia claimed her, Georgia named her, sweet Georgia Brown.